למעלות, וסעיני להרים, מאין יבוא עזרי.
Bishut Marei V'Rabotai, with the permission of Hashem, I would like to say this Dvar Torah, Le'inuy, some tzaddikim that pass away during Pesach. Rav Gruner, he was the secretary of the Rabbi Milubavitch. Harav Hagaon, Rav Gruner, Rav Agon, Rav Edelman, Shalom Edelman, Alav Shalom, he was a big friend of mine. He was 84 years old when he passed away on Friday, the day of Pesach, the second day of Pesach, and he was buried the same day because it was not possible to leave him another 2 days without being buried. So he was buried in Morocco on Friday, the second day of Pesach. He was a big friend of mine. And Le'i Nishmat Rav Ifegen Yaakov bin Phoebe, and Le'i Nishmat Rav Shmuel Moshe bin Shimshon Avraham HaKohen, that as well he passed away in New York last week. So may their soul rest in peace. It's very, very hard for me. Today we are Sunday, Chol HaMoed, Pesach. It's very hard for me to talk about them because we're not allowed to do hesped. We're not allowed to cry those tzaddikim. I know them very, very well. Especially the Gaon Rav Edelman from Morocco. He was the shaliach of the Rebbe Milubavitch in Morocco, with Rav Matyusov, with Rav Raskin, that now the three of them pass away. Rabbi Edelman, he was really the one that was taking charge of the kashrut of Morocco, Zikui Rabim. He did a lot of work all his life, more than 50 years. I know him when he was young. I was a baby. And last year, I was in Morocco, and I think 7 months ago, I went to Beit Chabad there, and the Rabbanich was there. He was not there, but his wife, she was there. I asked her, because they were doing there Gan Israel for the children. And I asked her, Madame Rabbanit, you still in Morocco? So she told me, where can I go? There is nowhere can I go. The Rebbe sent us to Morocco, so we have to stay in Morocco till the end. I'm sure that was her husband too. Her husband too, Arava Shalom, Rabbi Shalom Edelman. He was a big tzaddik. He was doing a lot of things for the Jewish people. Few times he went to give the bracha to the king of Morocco. He was very, very well respected by the Arabs and by the Jewish people, of course, who remained there. He took care of the mikvaot. We built a mikveh in Isawira in front of the ohel of Rabbi Chaim Pinto. He took care of that mikveh. He built it with all the halachot that we needed. And he went to Isawira a few times. He was with us in the hilula of Rabbi Chaim Pinto. And one day, a few years ago, when he saw thousands of people in Morocco, and he saw that they were tzniut, and he saw, you know, how the Jewish people there, they respected the, you know, the halachot of tzniut, the halachot of all the Dibrei Torah that they, that we were talking. He said, he told me, I wish in all the hilulot in Morocco, they do like what you do here in Rabbi Chaim Pinto. And a lot of times I was invited by him when I was in Morocco to go to his kollel, to his shul, to give there lectures of Torah. Unfortunately, he passed away with no thousands of people to be in his levaya. Only Rav Bannon, the son of Rabbanon of Montreal, he is as well a shaliach of the Rebbe. He took care of his rechitza, of his funeral on the day of Pesach. So, by his death, he left a big hole, a big emptiness in Morocco, the whole kingdom of Morocco. I'm sure today people woke up, or last night, and they heard that news, and unfortunately they buried him already because of the corona. Of course, today we're going to bury as well one of my big friends, Rabbi Meir Waknin. His son is in Manhattan. Unfortunately, he as well, he passed away because of this corona. The tzaddik Rav Gruner Alav Shalom as well, he passed away. He was the secretary of the Rebbe during maybe 40 years, 50 years. And of course, he knows a lot of things that we don't know about the Rebbe. But at least when he was alive, I saw him a few times in Paris, I saw him a few times around the world, it reminded me of the Rebbe. Now he went, he's next to the Rebbe. Of course, all of them are in Gan Eden, without forgetting Rav Ifegan Yaakov Ben Phoebe and Rabbi Shmuel Moshe Ben Shimshon HaKohen, Abraham HaKohen, that was a big Baal Chesed, big man as well. He passed away from this corona. The family of Rav Shmuel Moshe Ben Shimshon Abraham HaKohen, they are very well known, very, very well known by the chesed, by all the good things that they do. And how many hundreds of people they've been eating this Pesach through their tzedakah. My friends, I have to tell you something. Always since the corona started, I was worried about the parasha of this week, the parasha of Shmini, the parasha of the death of Nadav v'Abihu. Bemet, I told my wife, I told a lot of people, this parasha worried me, because usually always when there is tzaddikim who pass away, we compare them as Nadav v'Abihu, that they die when during the inauguration of the tabernacle, of the Mishkan. And I was very worried. But then I said to myself, well, with the Zichut of Pesach, Be'ezat Hashem, nothing bad will happen. Because this parasha, we read it, and it's as a parasha, usually when tzaddikim pass away, we compare the tzaddikim to Nadav v'Abihu, that they give their life for Hashem. My friend, Nadav v'Abihu, they were tzaddikim. But why did they pass away? Why did they die? their soul burned with the fire that came from the Shamayim. When Moshe Rabbeinu asked Aaron to inaugurate during 7 days, Moshe Rabbeinu was in charge to build the Beit HaMikdash, the Mishkan, and then to pack up all the Mishkan when he saw the Shekhinah did not come. But the 8 days, after 8 days, Moshe Rabbeinu said to Moshe, to Aaron, Aaron, today is the number 8. Today is the 8th day. During 7 days, I did the work of the Kohen Gadol. Now today, I'm going to do it again, but you're going to finish it. Because today, Hashem is going to appear. Why he didn't appear during 7 days? Why only now? That's because Hashem wants to give me the opportunity to do something. Now that I did what I did, and the Shekhinah did not come, that you are the only one who can bring the Shekhinah. You, Aaron HaKohen. You. So Aaron, prepare yourself, do the Korban Chata, the sacrifice of forgiveness for the Egel that you did, and do another sacrifice that Hashem will forgive all the Jews that they did the Egel. Now, the sin of the Egel will be canceled. And now Hashem is going to come. That's what the Torah says, Vayhi Bayom HaShemini. The word Vayhi, that means something is going to happen. Or happiness, or sadness. Happiness, it's the inauguration of the Mishkan. That day that Hashem is going to appear. That was the best day of happiness of Hashem, that never Hashem was happy like that day. But Vayhi is as well sadness. What kind of sadness? That day Nadav Abihu passed away. And Hashem said to Moshe Rabbeinu, tell the Jewish people to cry the death of this tzaddikim. Now, my friend, I have a question. If they are tzaddikim, why did they die that day? Why the day of the happiness of Hashem, they pass away? Why? Why? If they are not tzaddikim, I understand. But Hashem, he said, all Jews should cry. That meant the whole Jews should know that Nadav and Abihu are tzaddikim, and we should cry them. So the question is, so if they are tzaddikim, so what they did, it's perfect. So why they die? If it was perfect, it was not perfect. Perfect. This is the reason why they die. So why we have to cry them? And never mind. Why Hashem disturb that happiness? Why Hashem will not punish them another day? Why that day, right? That day, the day of the inauguration of the Mishkan, the day that Hashem appeared, the day that. That other Jews saw Hashem coming. Why that should happen? Why? And why Nadav Abihu choose that day? Why? Why did he could do it? Why did he could do something else another day? Why that day? My friend, I saw in a holy book, I don't remember the name of that book, he said something incredible. He said that Nadav Abihu, the day of the inauguration of the temple, they know that Hashem is going to forgive the sin that they did when they did the Egel, the idolatry, the calf, the golden calf. And Nadav Abihu decided, both of them, they said, well, now that Hashem is going to appear in front of all the Jews, that means that Hashem now is going to resign here with us. He will be the Mishkan. He will be inside every Jew. And then the sin of the golden calf that they did, it will be forgiven. maybe the Jewish people, do we think now that there will be in the Beit HaMikdash all kind of sacrifice for all the sin that we do, so maybe they will start to do Averot. Do we think that the Mishkan is here only to do their sacrifice for all the sin that the Jewish people will do? And then Jewish people, they will do a sin, they will do Averot. Why? Because we think, well, there is a Beit HaMikdash, there is a Kohanim, they do sacrifice, so they will do Averot, they will do sacrifice, and everything will be forgiven. So they decided, when the fire will come from the Shamayim, when it will come, and then the aureole of Asher will appear, we'll do a sin. And when we do that sin, so of course Asher will punish us. We'll get punishment right away. Then the Jewish people will know that, don't think because there is Beit HaMikdash, because there is sacrifice, you can do whatever you want to do. No. If you do something, you will get punished. So that means that Nadav and Abihu, what they did it only b'korbanam lifnei Hashem v'yamutu. They did that for Hashem, so that the Bnei Israel will be worried. So the Bnei Israel, we don't laugh. They will not take advantage of the Beit HaMikdash and to think that they can do whatever they want. No. If they do something, they will get punished. You understand? So now that's why HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he knows what they thought. What they did, it was Lishem Shamayim. What they did, it did it only for Hashem. And because they did it for Hashem, so HaKadosh Baruch Hu said to the Bnei Israel, you have to cry the death of Nadav v'Abihu. Because they did that for you. They did that you should learn that you can't mess around with the temple. You can't do whatever you want to do. If you do something, you get punished. So they did that as a teaching for you. So now you have to cry them. Now you have to bury them. And then we carry on the joy of the Beit HaMikdash. So that means, my friend, what they did it for Hashem. So all tzaddikim that pass away, why they pass away? They don't pass away because usually a tzaddik should not die. A tzaddik, because he's so close to Hashem, he should live. He should live all life. Why he die? Because when he die as well, it's a lesson for the Jewish people. What the lesson for the Jewish people? That the Jewish people will have to cry the death of the tzaddikim, and then to learn from them how to behave Hashem. Because a lot of times we take things as granted. A lot of times we think, after I do teshuva, after the teshuva. So HaKadosh Baruch Hu, what you do? Right away, take somebody to remind us that we should not joke. With Hashem, we don't joke. My friend, unfortunately, that parasha that I was afraid from, that parasha, Parasha Shmini, and that parasha, I lost a lot of friends, a lot of rabbis, unfortunately. One of them is Rav Edelman. Can you imagine Rav Edelman, alav shalom? I cannot believe, with all what he did, do that what he deserved? Damn it, huh? Do he deserve this? To be buried like a simple man, even not by Jewish people, that they have to take care of him, to wash him, pray for him, thousands of people, only by one person who was there with him, Rav Bannon. He was there to supervise that he did the hole, that they buried him, and he had to be alone and cry alone. Ay, ay, ay. What a mussar we have to learn from this. This is the way our tzaddik can be buried. That the way. It was one of the last generation of the Zikni Chabad. Yeah. Ah, Bikurbay HaKadosh, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he become holy with the death of those tzaddikim. That Hashem, if he can, if he take away people like that, like Rav Gruner, Alav HaShalom, big tzaddik like him, to be buried, you know, just before Pesach, with no people, with nobody with him, only few people. That man, that rabbi, thousands of thousands, they will be in his levaya, and there was nobody. This is a Corona Pesach. I was a lot of worried, as I told you before, that something may happen during this Parasha Shmini. We still not read it yet. We read on yesterday Shabbat, a part of it, but the Shabbat after Pesach, we will read it. Be'ezat Hashem, we pray to HaKadosh Baruch Hu that to stop all those dead people not to die anymore. Finished. Always HaKadosh Baruch Hu, take away the best. My friend, Korban, you know, on Pesach, we used to do Korban Pesach, the sacrifice of Pesach. This is a sacrifice of Corona. Through Corona, some holy souls pass away. Usually, when we had the Beit HaMikdash, we used to do the Korban Pesach, the sacrifice of Pesach, with joy, with happiness. While unfortunately, Rav Gruner, Alav HaShalom, he passed away, he was buried before the first Seder of Pesach, Wednesday night, Wednesday. That the time that they used to do in Beit HaMikdash, the Korban Pesach. That was like a Korban Pesach. And unfortunately, the second one passed away on Friday, the second day of Pesach. My friend, I was thinking that, of course, HaKadosh Baruch Hu, we're not allowed to talk. Why? What? Who can tell to Hashem, what do you do? HaKadosh Baruch Hu is the boss. But one thing I have to tell you. Do you think in a few years, we will be talking about this Pesach that the whole would spend. It was not a simple Pesach. Every Pesach we talk about Egypt, the exit of Egypt. And I would like to finish that after Be'ezat Hashem that this corona will pass away, Be'ezat Hashem we will be talking about this kind of Pesach that we've been together, we spend. I was reading a story about two tzaddikim, Rabbi Elimelech Melizinsk and Rabbi Zusha Meir, the two brothers, that they've been arrested by Polish people in Poland. And they give them a hole, they put them in a hole, and that hole was filthy. And there, they have to do their, you know. And there, they couldn't do tefillah, they couldn't do nothing. It was terrible, smelling. It was full of insects, mosquitoes, you know, jukim, you know, mice, you know, those kind of prison of before. It was terrible. And then, one of them, he wanted to say, to do mincha. So he said to his brother, hey, brother, mincha. So his brother told him, oh, how can we do mincha? It's impossible. We cannot do mincha. Look, his filth is smelling. There is here a small thing that they put there for things. You understand me? Like a toilet. There was not a real toilet, just something there. We cannot do. So he told him, look, we cannot do mincha here because it's impossible. How can you pray to Hashem? It's tuma, there is impurity, there is here, it's impossible. But you know what? There is another way how to pray to Hashem. How? Let's dance and sing. And they started dancing and singing. La 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 la. Singing, singing. And they started to swing, to sing, to sing. And then the people that they were in charge of the prison, they heard them making a lot of noise, screaming, dancing. They opened the door, what's going on? Well, we cannot pray. So we sing to Hashem. Why you cannot pray? Because there is here this dish that there is there, filthy, there is there, maim ktanim. Okay, we take it from there. So they took it from there. So he said to his brother, you see, now we can pray. My friend, we are now in Pesach. There is corona. We are afraid. Hard for us to pray. With all what's going on, it's hard. Our mind, it's not right. We are not. We cannot concentrate ourselves to pray as we should. Even feeling Pesach, it's hard to feel Pesach with all those bad news that we hear. A lot of people, but. So what we should do? We have to sing. We have to sing. And through singing, maybe Hashem would take this bad stuff, this corona, by being happy. This story, I read it in a small book. And the Musar from that story of Rabbi Elimelech Melizinsk and Rabbi Zusha Meir, that the most important thing, you have to create a way not to disconnect ourselves from Hashem. Those tzaddikim made the soul rest in peace. Hashem give you bracha v'atzlacha. Hashem bless you. Toda rabba. Amen.
Adonai ishmor lecha mikol ra. Ishmor et nafshecha. Adonai ishmor tzedcha uvoecha. Me'atah